Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. It's the dreaded reason a parent has to take off work. And it's the quote a kid never wants to hear mom or dad say, "Don't make me come up to that school." Well, that's exactly what the mom did to express her outrage about her daughter being bullied by her classmates. Mm. Take a look.
"Leave my daughter alone, and I'm not going to say it again. But if I have to go to every class, I'll do that. And I'm letting you know right now, any mom, any sister can catch these hands, okay? That's
period.
How pissed I am. Y'all gonna leave her alone. I mean, no messages online, don't post nothing about her. None of that. None of that. Y'all don't know me. Y'all think y'all bullies? I'm the big bully, okay? You don't pick them up. Whippings. Whippings for free. For free! You ain't even gotta pay for it. For free. Do y'all understand me?"
Wow, before we dive into the discussion about how we would or how we would have handled issues our children have had at school, it's important to note, reports state that this mother was ultimately escorted out of the classroom by the assistant principal and is banned from the campus. I think she delivered it very well.
I do too. I am team her.
Yes.
She did her thing, sis. True. She sure did.
Yes.
And you know what? It was well deserved, because I can guarantee you she just didn't wake up and go to that classroom.
Right.
Yes. That was a perpetual behavior displayed by those kids bullying her daughter, and she was fed up, and I don't like it.
Right.
And so she did the right thing.
I wonder if she went to the administration and the administration did nothing about it. I think that would be the catalyst for her going up there and then going actually to the classroom to address these students herself. Mm-hmm. Because, hey, I've gone to the proper channels. Mm-hmm. I've spoken to the teacher. Mm-hmm. I spoke to the principal, the assistant principal. What are you guys going to do about the safety of my child?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So I have to take this into my own hands.
And that was the statement that she made. She said, you know, what are you supposed to do when you've gone through the proper channels?
Absolutely.
You know, then what is next? What I found what was extremely entertaining in this video
come on with it.
Was the fact that the teacher
sat down.
Was like,
"Okay, girl." The teacher didn't want no smoke.
The teacher was like,
the teacher did not want any smoke, believe me.
And maybe the teacher too has talked to these children. You know, maybe she has already, you know, there has been a lot of different things and measures have been taken. A lot of measures have been taken and have not been effective.
Yes.
What's more important to me, and this is no shade to any of us. You know, we talk about the bonnets and we joke about the teachers and people coming up to school with the bonnets. But this is what I was talking about when I said we're so worried about mothers and stuff, people coming up to the school with bonnets and house shoes. Meanwhile, the kids are being bullied down in schools, and it has to go to measures where a parent has to come up to a school, go into a classroom, and check kids. Mm-hmm. What happened when at the door? Like, she got past the door, she got past the room. Like, what is happening in the school system where a parent has to stop everything they're doing to come up to a school and come and do a whole presentation
on
butt whoopings in a class on bullying that's not being fixed and addressed inside the school?
It's being ignored. If her daughter would have committed suicide, and we know that bullying a lot of times leads to that,
come on, mm-hmm.
then now everyone would have been up in an uproar. Oh my God, we didn't know that was happening. We would have helped. No, you wouldn't have. Yes. Why is it that a person must scream out for help before you make and take action?
Yep. Right.
I do not understand
that. And as a mother, as we, you know, did research on this story, you know, you're dropping your kid off to school and you look over and say, "Baby, have a good day," and she's crying because she's afraid of what is about to happen.
My child is in your care.
Yes.
She or he is in your care essentially for about 8 hours.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And while we're somewhere trying to work and take care of our kids and be stress-free, we have to feel in our hearts and minds. And see, to have a son who has special needs, this is why this is really, really, I'm real sensitive with this. Mm-hmm. And this is why I'm very crazy as a mother. And let me put a shout out to all the teachers in America right now that all my kids go to. I'm her, but I'm worse because I'm kids too. If you that age, oh baby, everybody's getting it. Mm-hmm. Everybody's getting it because my son has special needs. So he can't even come home and be like, "Mommy, somebody's, this person picked on me, or that person picked on me." He might come home with a whole bruise and been beat up and everything, and I would not be able to, he wouldn't be able to explain to me what happened.
Yeah.
That's the type of foolishness when we drop our kids off that we have to be nervous about all the time.
Yeah. Okay, but my question is, who's being protected at this point? Mm-hmm. The person being bullied or the person doing the bullying? Because I remember growing up, there were parent-teacher conferences, and if there was a situation, you were bringing parents from both sides to have a conversation.
Yes.
Or there's some phone calls being made throughout the course of the day.
You know, they say you can't do that now.
That's a big negative, soldier.
No, they say they say one time KJ got, you know, called a name or whatever, and I was in an uproar. It was a racial slur. And I went to the principal, and I was like, well, why can't we have a sit-down with the parents, you know, and just discuss why this little boy is always into an issue with my son? Mm-hmm. And they were like, well, policy states in Fulton County, North Fulton, that we can't have the parents see each other. I said, but I got Facebook.
But wait,
all
but
I gotta do is go
your
find
children. Your child can see mine right, and harass right,
exactly.
them on a daily basis.
But they won't let the parents sit down and talk.
That's a big negative. They don't want it. The discrepancy with that is that they're afraid that the parents may collide.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, something needs to happen.
Something needs to happen.
Exactly. Yeah. Now, in this case, and I think this is drastic measurements, I don't know if maybe the parent. It would have been better had she went to the superintendent, or maybe she did. But why would you have to uproot your kid and put your kid in a different school district yes. to avoid bullying? Yes. It has yes. to stop in the house of the
yeah.
school.
Yeah. Yeah. And the child is being, and normally the bullies are being bullied at home.
Mm-hmm. Or they may just be bad people, too.
But because children as a child, you ain't no bad person.
Well,
that's a learned behavior.
They need that behind
cut. I hear what you're saying.
I
hear what you're saying. But as much as we do to nurture and love on our children, they still become their own person. And if you see, as a mother, you see your child crying and fear of going inside, that your womb starts to shake.
No, I'm talking
shake.
About the bully.
No, what I'm saying like is, I'm just talking about from this particular situation, your womb starts to hurt because now you're hurting the seed that I have birthed.
You're
going inside. I think she did a great job.
Me too.
I would have done the same thing.
Yeah,
she was
a real classic.
It was very classic.
And she got tickets. She got tickets.
She said, it was free. She said, it doesn't cost anything. I got tickets. I said, oh, yeah, that's right.
She got real actual tickets.
And then she was like, you can have these hands. And it was perfect. It was absolutely, and here's the ticket, guys. Here's
I
the
love
ticket.
Her.
You have
the ticket, though.
I think you have to protect
free.
Your children.
You do,
charge.
At all costs.
At all
yep.
costs.
Free
you
of charge,
protect.
I love
and
it.
And people can say what they want about me as a parent all day long, but I don't care what people say, none of that. Well, you have to do, I don't care what you say. If anything happens to my child at the school, boom. Let me tell you something, it's going to be a lot of slow singing
and flower bringing.
If my cell phone starts to ring.
I know that's right.
That's all I got to say.
Well, there you go. Yep. There you go.
Yes, I'm gonna
throw this real quick in from Evelyn Braxton. I'm gonna tell you, she said, you mess with my child, there's gonna be two sad days. The day they bury you and my trial. Mm-hmm. That's what Evelyn Braxton says.
Come on, Missy.
Yeah.
And
she
raised
some real good kids.
That's
so
right.
There you go.
There
we
you
are
go.
Looking
in this world.
I'm trying to say.
Okay. All right. Woo.
Come on, folks.
Oh, my God. Okay, when it comes to parenting, gloves can easily come off when our children's sense of safety and self-worth is at stake. As mothers and women, it is our duty, come on, somebody, to protect our babies, our God-given right. But it's also the duty of those entrusted in their care while they're in school to work to do the same. We hope that mantra holds true in our kids' classrooms, because if they don't, we have absolutely no problem, not one, in coming down to the school
come on,
to help solve whatever issues arise, as you have seen. We love to hear how you feel. Send us your thoughts at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.